Are you blanketed in fear or covered by faith? Good morning, everyone. This is our reflection question for today. July 20, 1969 was one of the most eventful days in modern history. On that day, Neil Armstrong became the first human being to walk on the face of the moon. A whole series of preparatory flights had paved the way for that event. One was the flight of Gemini 4 in 1965. It was a four-day mission manned by astronauts Ed White and Jim McDivitt. On that flight, Ed White stepped outside the space capsule and made his famous 20-minute space walk. When that famous flight returned to Earth, a reporter interviewed White at length. One question he asked him was, what personal items he took with him on the flight? White said, one was the St. Christopher Medal, which had been given to him by Pope John XXIII. White went on to explain to the reporter, I took it to express my faith in myself, in Jim McDivitt, my partner, and especially in God. Faith was the most important thing we had going for us on that journey. In today's gospel reading, when Jesus showed himself for the first time after resurrection to his disciples, there was one person missing, Thomas. When told later that they had seen Jesus, he said he would only believe if he saw Jesus with his own eyes, with all his wounds, and touched them. The following week, as the disciples were huddled in the room, Jesus appeared, greeted them with peace, and asked Thomas to touch his wounds. Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe. Thomas utters one of the most powerful statements in the Bible, acknowledging Jesus' divinity, the only time anyone directly calls Jesus God, my Lord and my God. As Christians, we take comfort in Jesus' words, blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Faith is like one's physical health. Some of us are stronger than others. Either it is because of one's good care of his body, eating the right kind of food, and exercising regularly, or it is because of good genes. Similarly, one may have strong faith because his parents had a strong faith. This faith has been passed on to their children. On the other hand, weak faith can be had because one neglects it, does not live it out in his daily life, abandons it for the world. So how do we strengthen our faith? Faith is a gift from God. We can accept it and nurture it in much the same way that we can keep our bodies always fit by keeping a good diet and regular exercise. As we receive the Holy Eucharist prayerfully, being constantly grateful, practicing corporal and spiritual acts of mercy, and constantly make effort to follow the greatest commandments of God, loving Him and loving our neighbor, our faith grows stronger. In this pandemic time, we either practice faith or remain isolated in fear. Fear can have a desolating effect on us, can throw us into fits of anxiety or depression. Fear and doubt kept the disciples and Thomas isolated until Jesus came and gently brought them into his loving presence. We too can remain in our own little corner and allow ourselves to be defeated. Jesus comes to us today, wishes us peace, gently shows us his loving wounds, and extends his hands of forgiveness and compassion. As we celebrate this Sunday of the Divine Mercy, we reflect on God's infinite love and mercy for us. May our eyes and hearts remain transfixed on him, he who saved us by the precious blood of his Son. The Gemini 4 space journey reminds us of our own spiritual journey. From the now to the eternal, God's mercy lifts us up and carries our faith to great heights. Faith in ourselves, in one another, and especially in God. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, I have not seen Jesus, nor have I touched his wounds, but I believe that he is my Lord and my Savior. May this faith unite me with others and make me responsible for others who need my help, my mercy, and my compassion. This I pray in Jesus' holy and mighty name. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic faith and couples for Christ.